Related to interactive rendering, what's the biggest surprise to you over the past 10 years? Is there any new capability, platform, or social phenomenon that has stood out in your mind?
I think the way the games industry is really driving the graphics hardware vendors is very interesting to me. I've gone through several cycles in my career where the hardware goes from let's have a separate card for graphics to let's put it back on the CPU to let's go back out to the graphics card, and it sort of has this cycle. And now we're seeing the point where graphics cards have more power than the CPU in many cases with all the cores in them and the programmability. And the way that the vendors are working together with the games developers and with the other developers to try to figure out what is good to keep programmable. And as you know, if you can turn a given algorithm into a fixed function and just hard code in transistors, you have much better performance, like texturing.
Right.
It's one of those things where originally it was programmable, but then they put it into a fixed function to get the performance out of it. So working together with the industry, I really like the way that's going.
Uh-huh.
I didn't see that as much 20 years ago with the card vendors. They were sort of on their own, but now they have that collaboration going
right.
on.
Well, I mean, I think what we see with, you know, mobile and handheld devices is really a big disruption. And, you know, it has been amazing what's happening here. Like the amount of rendering power you have like in your pocket every day. Often I think like one way of, you know, just seeing how amazing it is, like if you sit down like in an airplane where they have another of those like touchscreen devices, but it's often like 5 or 10 years old because, you know, the upgrade cycles for airlines is so long, it looks like Stone Age technology compared to what you have in your pocket. So yeah, that's obviously something that is happening now, and it's pretty amazing.
With interactive, I mean, when I started doing rendering, it was very much on a desktop, you hit the render button and you came back the next day. And that was like a big thing for me and a big problem. So now to see live interactive web rendering is kind of blowing my mind. And I know that soon we'll be able to model in completely rendered lighted objects without having to, you know, hit the render button and dread the results. Yeah.